relaxation of the body that I think is on the top of all the most important things for a player, you know, the relaxation condition, and then comes all the other things. So the rhythm training, then the sight reading. If you think at a melody is composed, it's like water, you know, if we divide it, it's composed into rhythm and into intervals. And if we play them apart, it will be better after to put them together. Observe, if you observe nature, you see that nature, nothing is how you think it in. You say nothing seems to be what you see. Nature is always, it seems that nature loves to joke. You have to know, sometimes she loves to joke. For example, all our brain and body is cross wired. So all the left side of the body is connected to the right side of the brain. And all the right part of the body is connected to the left part of the brain. So, you know, this kind of changing things, you know, putting them where you don't think they are, it seems that life and nature would love to say to us, we have always to be active, to try to explore, not to fit into a habit. So, one important thing that I realize, and it's not yet scientifically proven, tested, but they're coming to that, is that the brain doesn't see, if we read a word, the brain doesn't see only one way. If we divide the hemispheres into two parts, if I really love, there's a part that is what we call a mirror part, you know, so it's reversed. The other parts are what we call flip down. Are flip down, so each part, you know, is flip down. So when today I'm going to speak about then the melodic shapes, we'll understand why we have begun from this point of view. For that reason, I even researched the ancient languages that often were written this way, you know, like ancient Greek, the Boustrophedon way of reading, and even other places in the world. And I discovered this one, practicing with myself and with my students, that if you played only 15 minutes in a sort of discipline kind of reading, you will see after a quarter of an hour that something more activating is happening inside. You will feel that this quarter of an hour seems to be quite 1 hour, because it's going to form quite a bridge, you know, between the two hemispheres, where these neurons they remain active. In fact, one of the most important principles of neuroscience is that neurons, when get fired, they get wired. It means that when two neurons can recognize one each other, they still remain the communication between them. And I noticed that reading, practicing and reading, even in this unconventional manner, something more enhancing happens. And so I prepared on my website even some tests that you can download very soon and try yourself, you know, after quarter of an hour reading what happens. Happen many things, but I would like, you know, if what I say could be only theory, I would like you after to practice. But the important thing is that I can explain what happens. If we read in an alternative way, left, right, and right, left, happens that the optical nerve gets very relaxed. So after a while, even the muscle of the face were relaxed more. And there's a sort of two hemispheres. Why? Because while the left hemisphere is more connected with reading, you know, with writing, the right one, among other things, but has one special thing very important that is important for us musicians, that is connected with time and space. As you know, time and space, we can divide time and space. So that's why you will see after now, I will show you, if you read interacting with a special with some paths, I'm going to call them paths, you know, with the eyes, something different happens. It's more than reading and stop and in the conventional way. Anyway, reading left to right music is a standard we have to accept all the world, so we can't change that, even for a Chinese or a Hebrew. They have to read music that way. And that's what I say at the end, if you play by heart everything, you know, disappears, because by heart you have only to remember. But that is our goal, you know? We have to prepare for that. So, I call even holistic, because as they play both classical and jazz, there are many things that they can, you know, they can share together that are similar. And one important thing that I think it can be very helpful for the classical player is the conception of melodic shape. A melodic shape is the design of the contour of a melody. But we have only to begin with four notes. You know, four notes. Imagine four notes melody, and we can have basically four, 10 melodic shapes. If you think, you know, four notes, ba 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 ba. You say, okay, where can I go? If you see in the first, this is the first what I call the sheet you have is daily exercises, you know, and I have divided into the 10 melodic shapes, so it's all already there. So the first melodic shape is the one where we are going. We have four notes have three directions, if you think, because starting for the first, you go one step, do re, another step, re mi, and another step. Okay, so we have always three jumps. Okay, so the first one of the shapes is up, 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 and it's the first you see. And the second is what I said before, is the reverse one. So it's down, down, down. Okay. Is down, down, down. And in this case, I think there's no doubt of for the moment, there's no doubt of how playing this music. But after we will go deeper. Now I try to explain all the melodic shapes. So the first two melodic shapes are quite easy to recognize, because they are linear, you know? Or I go straight up, or I go down. The second melodic shape, if you see, it goes the third. It goes up, up, and down. Okay, up, up, and down. Now, these are even patterns, daily patterns. You know, we can use every day, even if you are classical or jazz players. I don't know here, but I think that most of you are mainly classical. Anyway, you can play. There's no difference if you are a rock player or jazz or classical. You know, this is the training is for all of you on this kind. What you can see is we turn to the first stage. You know, that it seems so linear and easy. Okay. What is the difference? What is really the difference of this chart? That it seems that you can end it in few minutes or quickly, but it's not. If you see it profoundly, it's not that. It's you know, you get wider and wider. But you have to know to train yourself how to do. You know, if you see there are seven letters, you know, A from G to G. Okay. Because when we think to a progression, when we think to a pattern going on a scale, we think So the end you have to put it, you know, and it's something that the classical player has to do, has to add something, you know, himself. There's a little request of a little effort to do something, but when you understand it, it gets easier. But the most great thing is that it's very it can give you other opportunities to play, and you will see. So if you play the first day, if you read only what is written, you think, and then what I have to do, but if you play it. Second state, there's no doubt. I'm sure that if you think that I'm going up in this way with the first melodic shape, when I go down, it's all also clear. Okay. The third state is not perhaps. Now we will see what happens. If I play this pattern of all the third melodic shapes, that is up, up, down. Now I play only one octave, so it is easier. So if I play. This pattern. down with the same pattern, so it's a sort of going backward in this way. If you think it seems different, because it seems different, it doesn't seem that I'm using the same pattern to play. Interpret where you want to go. So this could be even enough. And these three exercises are progressive. So you have this, you have three charts with different intervals with the 10 melodic shapes and in all the keys. So you can play the same thing in all the keys. So very interesting. And okay, another now, if I tell you, if you have this kind of chart, do you, and you want to explore something different, do you perhaps see that you can read in another manner? As a classical player, usually he's accustomed to read only what he sees, and but this is thrilling for him. It's interesting. You have many ways to play, but what I suggest is to think the best way that is different from the other, or simply another way psychologically seems to be different, and it's okay the same. Perhaps another way of playing is A1. Right left, B2, right left, C2, right left. If I had to write all the way we can play here, I have to write 6 pages. But it's not for this reason that I made only one. It's because we have to read even right left, because it's something that activates both the hemispheres. That is the most important thing that I saw. And when you return reading in a normal way, you see that you feel different. You feel like open wide eyes. Something happens that even the thing is not you who is playing. I still say, I don't know why things are coming, but I don't know why. Because you know, there's an activation side. So the other way to play, perhaps these are only ideas. You can play. You can have others. The other way is A1, B1, but I'm going forward, but I'm reading right left. So it goes in this way. Okay, simply. In this case, and if I go to go down, how am I going to read? I'm going to read. I can begin where I want, but perhaps I begin from B2, one octave higher. So I will go this way. Okay. Sometimes we don't have the right extension to finish, of course, because we don't have all the range, but we have to fit inside this kind of ring. Okay? On the third melodic shapes, third stage, reading in the opposite side is different, because you know the third normal way is if I already read A3 right left, it becomes jazz player. Even if you know, even in classical playing, we have many compositions where perhaps we have to improvise something. So I think even the classical player has to know a little bit about improvisation. And perhaps you have a new composition written, but it's all written, but you have to play in a jazz style. So in this case, you can imagine how the melodic shapes, where go the accents for a jazz playing. Because the third stage goes with a jazz playing goes. Right left goes. Okay, so usually when there's the peak, we put the accent. So you can do, you know, what you want about this chart. You can switch and play. You can change the mouthpiece for the jazz mouthpiece and try to play your sight reading goes a little bit more efficiently, you know, and you can test that. So it's a good thing that you can do this yourself. This is the chart of the daily exercises. Other things you can have. This is the diatonic. These are patterns. Diatonic patterns is something similar. But it goes on opening your mind. You know why? Because there are, it's quite like a magic square. You know, the magic square where you can read in this way, in the other way, vertically from down to top. You know, you have to explore. You have to explore this. So, the first one, so this is the diatonic pattern. Even the first chart is C major. You have a simple pattern that you see, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, okay, the first pattern. B, C, D, E, F are the six main permutations of the sequence. You know that if we have an A, B, C, D sequence and we change it, 1, 2, 3, 4, we have 24 patterns, 24, but only six are the ones that are different if you play in a way that is like, you know, that the mechanical exercises, the one who began John Dex, even other ones. So the first chart, you can play even if you want, bring it each sequence only and play like a mechanical exercise. So you can do, okay, and then you go on. If you want to play this way, it's okay. The interesting thing I think is when you switch your way of seeing, and you see that there are six vertical columns. You see them? Okay, so now it's just different. You have other clues, other pieces. So you can play. But as I said before, this is a dynamic flowing chart. You don't have to begin there. You can even begin. So I noticed that if you play in this way, something happens that harmonizes both hemispheres, and you will feel in a good mental estate for playing. You know, you will find yourself. You can run in the mail. You know how it was, or even your doubts. Okay, I accept critics. It's okay. So the vertical play. It seems not to be nothing special. I can play even vertically A1, descending but going right to left. I can play. Okay, this could be. You left, right, descending. I play A2, right, left. So it goes, you know Tai Chi Chuan? You know Tai Chi Chuan? All this kind, if you think, you know, they begin with one way, then they go to the other. Because it's always a sort of balancing, you know? Balancing. To have a healthy mental state, not only healthy, but to enhance our mental state for playing. We have to try to to wire the most neurons as possible, and to do that we have to do something that involves all the hemispheres. And as I said before, the right hemisphere is strongly connected with time and space. So I have inserted time and space in our reading, and I saw that something special happens. But you have to try yourself. Okay, so. Another way of playing this one that begins to go inside the method is playing A1 left right, A2 right left. So it becomes. Okay, I repeat. A1 left right, A2 right left, and then I go on. Coherent, you know. Sometimes we will hear about this brain training, but sometimes they are fighting against one another, you know. Coherent means I think that time, working with time and space, is coherent. Because if I ask you, you know, when we study, we think about rhythm. Perhaps we tell the feeling, you know, feel and say okay, and then the teacher said no, don't have the feeling, we have to feel inside. But if I tell to all of you, when we feel inside the rhythm. When it comes that we can feel inside the rhythm, how we feel that rhythm, what happens? When I ask this question, it hasn't a so easy answer. How I feel my rhythm inside. One can say, oh, I feel it with the body. Okay, it could be. But I think you could agree that what we feel about the rhythm is a sort of impulse. We feel an impulse that. Is quite the director, you know, that helps us to perceive the rhythm. So what we call the inner senses are very important to get developed. Mm-hmm. And really in this way, really activate something different happens. But as I say, I would like you to try it, you know. So this is what I call the DNA emotion, because emotion like this, okay. There are other motions that's written and explained, but the basic idea is the infinite motion. So we have this kind of plane, the infinite, okay, and then there's another kind of plane that is horizontal, but it's still this Tai Chi movement that always try to balance what we say, okay. So this is very important. I'm developing the rhythm conception, I'm developing how to memorize. There's a lot of two things to do. Because, you know, little by little, if you think, we study perhaps hard 3 years, you know, and then after 3 years we say, oh, okay, great, my technique has gone very well. But now we are beginning to see how, strictly how our progress is going on. You know, so we can say, oh, okay, it's good, I'm going on. Not to be so mental fix, you know, not for that, but to even for the students to that is quite a sort of help. So in this way, you can in the test I will put on the my website, you could test memorization, I should, you know, help Helen another masterclass because it's another big deal, as you say, you know. Anyway, you can think of this. We have the short memory. So if I play to you a sequence of perhaps 16 notes, I think it will be difficult for you to repeat them. Some areas that are hard for you to remember, and so you have to play more with these areas, and then after they are improving, you will get better. Generally, everything is going to improve. It's quite a sort of improving the dark side of our unconscious. Of, you know, this all this big part is the most big part, the biggest part, you know, and then little by little. I'm seeing the best way to improve. But begin with a short memory term. Try to see how many notes you can remember. And you have to write what your state, your physical state in different